And welcome to RTC TV. My name is Jared Michael, and I'm here with Chevy Teeter. We are in Tippecanoe Valley getting ready for an exciting evening of high school football. It is September 30th, and tonight's matchup is between the Tippecanoe Valley Vikings and the Rochester Zebras. The Vikings have had a tough season so far this year, record of 1-5. However, they were able to capture their first win against Manchester Squires last week. Under the direction of Coach Ed Shriver, the Vikings have been a very run-heavy offense with a fundamental defense. I know the tensions have been high for the Vikings this week, as this is their biggest rivalry game, and they try to take back the bell.
Rochester has struggled against their competition this year, with a record of 0-6. Looking for their first win tonight, the atmosphere tonight may provide what the team needs. Last year, the Zebras were able to keep a hold of the bell, and they will not part with it without a fight.
For offense for the Vikings, at QB, we have number 5, Alec Craig. Fullback, we have number 82, Genoa Melanimi. Halfback, number 12, Deshaun Heckman. At split end, we have number 7, Chris Sechrist. At wing, we have number 15, Wes Melanson. Tight end, number 40, Bryce Webster. At left tackle, we have number 72, Michael Pasica, and at right tackle, we have number 77, Evander Wimsatt. Left guard, we have number 52, Jonathan Daly, and right guard, we have number 79, Dalton Webb. At center, we have number 74, Hunter Hyde. On defense, our defensive tackles are number 67, Jameson Baker, and number 56, Dalton Prater. Defensive end, we have number 40, Bryce Webster, and number 62, Austin Vining. Our inside linebackers are numbers 52, Jonathan Daly, and 82, Genoa Melanimi. At outside linebacker, we have number 15, Wes Melanson, and number 83, Devin Bandout. Cornerback, we have number 16, Tanner Trapedi, and number 3, Cameron Parker. For safety, we have number 5, Alec Craig.
Rochester's starting lineup is number 15, quarterback Brad Praise. Number 10, fullback Bryce Abbott. 32, wide receiver Ross Pearson. 30, the tight end is Wilson Dalton. 20, another wide receiver is Corbin Wood, and the other wide receiver is 7, Corbin Wood, Isaiah Wood. The tackles are number 51, Tyler Walker, and 77, Chandler Lame, and the left guard is Austin Foster, number 63, 76. Right guard is Anthony Tinsman, and center Zane Gilbreth at number 74.
Now, I know the Valley 4 Valley versus Rochester has been very high. Lots of tension at the schools, lots of pump up. I know Valley was playing kind of this game's theme song over and over throughout the day as they prepare for it. Just some quick stats here. Rushing yards per game, leader number 12 for the Vikings is Deshaun Heckman, and that's an average of 47 yards per game, as compared to Rochester's number 10, Bryce Abbott, who's at 53.3 yards per game. For passing yards per game, we have Alec Craig, 76.5 yards per game, compared to number 15, Brady Perez, 42 yards a game. You can definitely tell that that the Vikings have been very pass-heavy early on in the season as compared to later. Now we are more run-heavy. For total yards per game, we have number 5, Alec Craig, 96.2, and number 15 for the Rochester Zebras, Brady Perez at 85.3. As the Vikings run out onto the field, they are definitely ready for tonight's matchup.
Definitely a lot of hype tonight, Jared.
I agree, Chevy. I know they are wanting to bring back the bell. In the past 2 years, Rochester has won the bell both times and kept a hold of it, which the Vikings haven't been too proud of.
And even without the bell, I feel like this game, they really want to prove that they're capable of keeping their aggression strong. There's a big rivalry here. And
now, you can see out there on the run out, there is a Zebra appears to be getting beaten by a Viking as the Rochester Zebras are running out on the field now. And you can tell that they are also ready for this game. They seem pumped up, and they're looking for their first win right here. So, really, first win against the Vikings in the bell game would be enough to increase their morale for the season, I believe, and help them out to get some more wins later on.
That it would.
Now, right now, it's early on in the evening. It's a little chilly with a little bit of wind, but the Zebras right now fans are just not quite here. Don't know if that's time or whether they're just not ready yet, but Vikings are definitely showing strong in tonight's game.
I believe the stands are almost full for the Vikings tonight.
I believe you're right, and with these new stands, they're a little bit wider. They hold some more people, so I believe this is a record for these stands. It is a beautiful night for high school football. It is perfect. Those pads on, they're not going to be getting too hot. Hopefully we won't see too many injuries or any cramping, things of that nature. That's normally getting out towards the beginning of the season. I know Valley was plagued with injuries early on this year.
That they were.
Right guard number 79, Dalton Webb.
Right now they're doing the starting lineups for the Vikings.
Introducing the players, as you can tell there's definitely a lot more hype here. It's almost crazy the amount of excitement.
You know, I think that Valley had a pep rally right before school ended, and I think some of that pep has carried over into this game, and the Vikings are ready to play.
Yes.
Rochester seems a solid line as preparing. And the captains for both teams are walking out onto the field. Captains for Rochester, number 64, Zane Gilbreth. And others. Again, we're live here on RTC.
He was a very dynamic player in North Miami. He did not play college football, went down to IU.
And the shaking of the hands. Also captains for the Zebras, number 31, Ross Pearson, 65, Austin Foster, and 15, Brady Perez.
Switch off in a couple seconds.
But still, growing pains for the Zebras. They've really struggled.
Now, I'm really wondering how polite the teams are going to be tonight. I know there's a lot of tension there in between these two teams, as this is the biggest rivalry of the year for the Vikings and the Rochester Zebras.
And this is one of the biggest rivalries in the conference, let alone, I'd say, in the state. There's definitely a very big rivalry here.
And the Vikings will be kicking off.
You know, Valley has had some luck getting the ball back off kickoffs. Let's see if we can do that early and put a little hurt on the Rochester Zebras.
Now it'll be number 71, Jose Rivera, kicking for the Vikings.
Very short kick by Jose. And they take him down right around the 35.
That'll be the start of the first quarter of this game. 11:55 left to play right now. Now, Rochester in a pistol formation.
It looks like a loss of a yard.
You know, both the Zebras and the Vikings have been struggling this year offensively.
That they have. But these last couple games, Valley's really turned it around, as what for what I've noticed.
Up front for the Zebras, Tyler Walker, Austin Foster, Zane Gilbert, Anthony Tinsman, and Chip.
Running trips to the left. Quick little screen pass to number 20, Corbin Wood, a junior.
Corbin Wood, the junior, means a couple.
Corbin Wood, the ball carrier.
Good pass, senior.
Well, let him catch the pass.
Team tackling for the Vikings.
Rochester definitely wanting to utilize some elements there, mixing up the running and the passing, keeping Valley on their toes. Let's see how that works out for him in this game.
So far in this game, for the first couple plays, Valley doesn't look that bad on their defensive abilities.
Again, that pass was intended for number 20, Corbin Wood. Junior, being at 6 foot, you know, normally you can get that ball up there and he can just reach out and grab it. However, the Vikings have some pretty big defenders, so.
Yeah, and it didn't look like there was too much communication there.
That'll bring up fourth down. And that'll be a quick little punt there.
And there it didn't even look like they were going to punt.
Now here's going to be the Vikings' first drive of the night. Number 5, Alec Craig, under center, bobbles.
And a fumble, but it looks like we got it back.
That'll be number 79, Dalton Webb on the recovery. He's just a freshman. Vikings are going to try their second down here. Zebra showing that they are ready to play.
And not a big gain there, but see what Valley can do on this third down.
Third and seven. You got to wonder if Vikings are going to go for a pass here. That'll be a handoff to number 13, Jared Dusenberry, senior for the Vikings.
The way it's looking, this may be a very close game.
Dusenberry with the long punt, something he's been doing a better job as the year goes on and the season progresses. Rochester will take over the ball at 8:47 left on the clock.
So far this game's looking just like back and forth, back and forth. Let's see if we can get a little bit more hype going.
And that'll be a breakaway.
And
for the Zebras, number 20, Corbin Wood. Definitely who the Zebras are relying on so far this game. Big plays like that can make a big difference in a game.
And that is not what Valley wants. They want to bring that ball home, and they let that happen too many times. We may be hurting.
And that'll be brought down quickly. That's quarterback number 15, Brady Perez, just a sophomore starting for the Zebras.
And it looks like Shane Ellis is hurt and limping off the field.
You know, he's just coming back these past couple of weeks. Started off at the beginning of the year, like we said earlier, about the injuries that have plagued the Vikings throughout this year. Shane hurt his ACL early on in the year, and he's just coming back, so he's got to work his way back through it. Brought down quickly by the Vikings.
7:23 to play in the first quarter. No score yet. Dave Valley. Thomas on David Musselman.
One first down.
Third down. It is well. No first down. Lower wide left. Pearson wide left. 40 yards.
You know, with going how the Zebras have been playing so far, you got to wonder if there's going to be a pass here.
And called off sides there.
You know, that's a quick, easy 5 yards that the Vikings just gave him there. It's long counts like that can definitely help you out in a game.
Yeah.
Still third down, 6:57 left to play in the first quarter. Looking for a pass. Very hard, lots of defenders there.
Nearly picked off.
Nearly picked off. Almost picked up by Rochester, so quick thinking there, but just not quite able to do it. Got to wonder if they're going to bring out the field goal squad. It looks like they're going to go for it here. That'll be a timeout for the Zebras. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back. And we're back. We are live at RTC4.com, also filming on Channel 4 on cable. 6:40 left to play in the first quarter. And that'll be a pick by number 3,
Cameron Parker.
Cameron Parker, just a sophomore. Definitely what the Vikings needed in that situation.
Definitely.
However, flag thrown. That'll be a sideline violation on the Zebras. You know, it's really hard with such a big game like this to keep your players back, that you just they all want to be in the game at the same time, and you just got to tune that back a little bit and let them use that on the field.
That they do.
I know the refs have been definitely working on the sidelines a lot more so far this year. Vikings having trouble with that early on in the season. That'll be number 12, Deshaun Heckman, senior, on the sweep.
Not a gain of much there, but it's something.
That'll be a gain of 2 for the Vikings. Half the time gone, 6 minutes left in the first quarter. Alec Craig is going to roll out, number 5, senior. He also has been starting quarterback since he was a sophomore, as well as Brady Perez for the Zebras.
Craig has a lot of experience back in his pocket, and he knows how to scramble, and hopefully we can see him break a couple good runs and get a couple good passes today.
Vikings holding in that wing T formation under center. That'll be another handoff to number 12, Deshaun Heckman. Able to rush forward for the first down.
First down and 10, and again, right now he's not playing any defense. So he has to concentrate solely on the offensive side of the ball. First down and 10.
Now, Deshaun Heckman last game had over 100 yards rushing. And that'll be number 82, Genoa Melanimi, on the carry
with a great, great run there.
Oh, showing that power. Looks like he got hit in the knee there and just struggling to get up a little bit. Showing it that power and how it can be used with speed.
Let's just hope he's cramping up a little bit and he'll be all right.
Vikings sub out Genoa for number 3, Cameron Parker, sophomore. The one who was able to make that interception early on, which gave the Vikings this drive here.
Cameron Parker may be a smaller guy, but he definitely has power.
Rochester players slow to get up. He's up, and thankfully he's okay.
Rochester has a surprisingly taller team, for what I've noticed. Maybe that's why Valley hasn't passed so much.
Flag on the play. 4:04 left to play in the first quarter.
This first quarter flying by, and still a scoreless game.
Zebras deciding what to do here. It looks like the Zebras are going to take the penalty, which was an illegal movement there for the Vikings.
That's one thing Valley has struggled with a little bit. Their illegal procedures and just getting caught a couple times.
Yeah, Vikings definitely hurting in fundamentals. Quick pass to the tight end number 40, Bryce Webster Jr., showing how he can use that 6'4", 223 frame that he has to just hop up there and get the ball. He's definitely been a good go-to receiver for Craig when Alec is getting very crowded back there in the pocket.
That he is.
Vikings marching down the field, slowly but surely. Run game just draining the clock. Fast, 3:18 left to play. Alex going to run out wide, showing that speed that he has.
Definitely a great fake handoff there to DJ Heckman. Definitely tricked Rochester a little bit.
You know, he was brought down by his coattails by number 15, Brady Perez. Well, it's kind of funny, quarterback taking down a quarterback there. So.
Especially Rochester, they get down. right.
This seems how do they handle an emotional down?
Parker is your fullback. He's behind Greg in the slot on the right side. That's Heckman. Heckman in motion to the near side. Picks the handoff to him.
Quick handoff to number three, Cameron Parker, sophomore, showing those spin moves that you often see in games like Madden and NCAA.
Very impressive.
You know, he doesn't have that size to really drive through like Genoa. Cameron's only 5'8 at 155, wherein Genoa there is 5'9, 212. So that muscle and mass just isn't quite there to push through the right through the gut, wherein he can use his speed for it. They're going to bring out the chains here to see if that's first down. You know, it looks like that'll be a first down for the Vikings.
First and 10, Vikings.
First down for Timothy Valley.
5 on the play, and it is a first down.
Number 26, so the righteous Valley is coming for your hash.
That's got his number 4.
And 220 to play.
Is all on this drive. 2:22 to go in the opening quarter, no score. Timothy Valley now has driven the ball to the Rochester 26-yard line.
2:17 left to play in the first quarter. That'll be number 12, Deshaun Heckman, the senior for the Vikings, brought down quick.
Gain of 1 there.
Vikings so far this season have had a hard time with their front line. You know, just showing those problems with the fundamentals.
Craig will hand it off. This time it's Jonathan Fields, and the senior takes advantage of his first down. Jonathan Fields, chain of five on the play, and we'll bring up a third down and four. Just as we talked about for Rochester, the other end of the field, this is definitely four down territory for the Vikings.
Trying to,
it's not very well
on my trying to go.
Yeah, they have, and they've really changed the field position. They want to walk away with all of
to cut.
So we'll see what the Vikings have.
Third and 4 for the Vikings. We'll see what Rochester 20-yard line.
Rochester near hash. Has a line up as well. Sigrist behind the left.
I did the right
left
side.
Webster and Melanson to the far side.
Back formation. Field to fullback. Craig in the center.
How we doing?
And off goes the Heckman.
That'll be Heckman driving forward.
Great drive by Heckman. He's still going. Still going. Very good run by Heckman.
Almost to the end zone. You can definitely tell he's looking for that, looking to get that first score of the game.
And that was great teamwork, the whole team pushing him just inches farther.
You know, and those inches really matter. 30 seconds left to play. Can the Vikings score here before the end of this first quarter?
They may want to hurry up if they're going to try to pull that off.
Looks like they'll have one more play before the end of this quarter. That'll be another handoff to Heckman, who's brought down quickly. That's the end of the first quarter. Vikings on the 1 yard line. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be right back.
And we're back.
Start of the second quarter, 12 minutes on the clock. Vikings at the 1 yard line, definitely prepared for the score. We are live at RTC4.com, also live at Channel 4 on cable. That'll be a handoff to the senior number 44, Jonathan Fields, brought down behind the line of scrimmage for a loss.
Valley's definitely going to have to push because I don't think Rochester wants to give this up.
Vikings definitely looking for the score here. They almost need it to satisfy that want of this bell game. And that'll be a quick pass to number 40, Bryce Webster, for the first score of the game. 11:15 left to play in the second quarter.
And I bet they're all feeling, hearing some ringing in their ears of the bell.
You know, and you gotta love that. I remember it from when I was younger. The cannon here at the stadium for the Vikings here, definitely showing the score and giving a little more school spirit here. Kick is up and it is good.
Let's see if Valley can keep it up.
And that was number 51, Domingo Santiago, a freshman on that kick. You know, he's been doing a good job with PATs so far this year.
That he has.
Number 71, Jose Rivera, kicking off for the Vikings. Second time that they have kicked off so far this half. Back to return for Rochester is number 20, Corbin Wood, Jr., and number 31, Ross Pearson, Sr.
A little bit longer kick from Valley this time. A spin there.
Corbin Wood showing the athleticism that he possesses. Finally brought down by number one, Dwight Conley. Vikings having a hard time wrapping up there and bringing him down. You know, that's a huge morale boost for the Zebras.
Yeah.
Looking for that after the Vikings score for the first time in this game.
They've had two great returns there, so they're getting what they need.
Vikings have been struggling on kickoff so far this year. Jose Rivera is able to kick it off long, but Vikings having problems with over pursuing. And that'll be a pass to number 31, Ross Pearson.
Valley not letting them gain very much there, but.
You know, Ross is a senior this year. And you're able to see how, you know, a sophomore as a quarterback can rely on his senior leaders there. It's very hard as a sophomore to be stepping in that leadership position. And it can put a lot of stress on him.
Great stop there by the Vikings.
Vikings showing that they are not afraid to do group tackles, which they've been struggling with early on in this season. Yeah. You know, you can see the head coach, Jeff Shriver, on the sidelines with the Bring the Bell Back t-shirt on, showing that Death Valley t-shirt that he's got on. They're bringing that name back, trying to bring back some pride. Zebra's able to get a nice pass there and move the chain gang.
You know, both teams are doing a great job on just narrowing down the clock and not allowing the other team to have very much ball time.
Vikings having a hard time so far defending the pass. That pass was to number 30, Wilson Dalton. He's a sophomore, too. Not quite bringing up the first down. And that'll be a handoff to number 30, Wilson Dalton, showing that he can run as well as catch the ball there.
And that's going to give Rochester a first down.
Rochester looking to answer for the Vikings' first score there. Low snap, quarterback number 15, Ben Perez, just taking the ball down, rather take a loss than have to worry about fumbling it again.
That could hurt them, or that could be a smart move.
You know, the Viking defenders were right there, ready for him. If he would have picked that ball up and tried to run with it, would have been very sad to see what would have happened to the quarterback there.
Yeah. Got to keep his health in mind as he's playing.
As a sophomore, it's great to see him having good field sense like that. Flag on the play. You can see how the Viking defense is definitely ready for the passing game. They were struggling earlier on in this drive, but looks like they've got that tuned down. Penalty on the Zebras. That'll bring up second in California. 7:27 left to play. 24 yards to get the first down for the Zebras.
It's a long way for a first down. And they're letting them start with the first down here.
Chang Gang having a little bit of trouble there. Valley looks hungry for that ball, definitely looking for the interceptions and the fumbles. Rochester the same.
Great game so far by Devin Bandow.
Rochester playing more of a controlled pace right now. The Vikings definitely looking to rush the clock. And, you know, it's going to be who can set the tempo here that can make the big difference in this game. Is Rochester going to fall prey to the Vikings' rush tempo, or are they going to keep back their nice methodical pace? That was a great attempt to number two, Jerry Plummer. Tanner Trapedi showing what the Vikings have been working for of the contact after the ball has been in the receiver's hands.
Now, today at the pep rally, Coach Jeff Shriver, he said he wants to bring the contact back. He wants to make this a very contact-heavy game. He wants to put the hurt to him.
That'll be a quick little punt there. Short kick out to the out of bounds. That'll be the Vikings taking over. Rochester fans still not quite showing up to this game. I'm wondering if this is going to be all the more that appear for the night as Vikings get ready for their next drive. Brought down by many Zebra defenders. Alec Craig still under center. Senior showing that as he started as well as a sophomore, as Brady Perez did, that those years of experience can help you and learn with field experience there. Field vision showing where the ball needs to go and what needs to happen. Number 13, Jared Dusenberry, senior coming in for the Vikings. Half the second quarter done with, 6:01 left to play. Alec Craig, quarterback, will keep the ball there. You can see the Zebras are definitely there matching up size for size with the Vikings as Jared Dusenberry is now having to punt because of their ferocity.
That's one thing I figured.
That'll be a bobbled punt return. Fumbled.
Like Rochester got it, but that seems to be what it's going to be.
Just kind of dropped down through his arms and wasn't able to get it there.
But as I was saying, this is just as I thought. I figured that it'd be a pretty close game. Very bad.
Rochester's going to take over. 5:16 left to play in the second half, or in the first half, second quarter. That'll be a handoff to number 31, Ross Pearson, senior.
Back faked.
Faked, and number 15, Brady Perez, quarterback, able to keep it. Flag on the play. Great fake by the Zebras. That'll be holding on the Zebras. Play resumes here. Zebra spread wide. Quick pitch.
a little trip up back there.
That'll be a timeout for the Zebras. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be right back. And we're back. Cheerleaders showing the school spirit that the Vikings have. Again, 4:20 left to play in this first half. Vikings 7. Rochester's very spread out to the left side of the field. Quarterback again doing an option play. Quick pitch out. Rochester struggling with those option style plays so far this game.
The only real success I've seen that they've had is their pass game.
Brady Perez back. Looks like it's going to be a sack for the Vikings. That'll be brought down by number 44, Jonathan Fields. Showing just a little bit of gumption there and some happiness after that sack.
Exactly what Valley needs.
Viking fans definitely up and ready to cheer for their team as Rochester brings out the actual punt squad here.
I feel like it's not just the team that wants the ball back. I feel like it's the whole community.
Bad punt by the Zebras. You know, it just kind of glanced off of his foot there, so he wasn't quite able to get it. 2:41 is when the Vikings will be taking over on this drive. Now you can tell that the Vikings are pumped up there on the sidelines. Vikings getting ready for their drive here. 2:41 left to play. Hand off to number 3, Cameron Parker.
And maybe a loss of 2 there.
You know, Cameron Parker, sophomore, was showing early on in this game. This is his first time really playing. After Genoa Melanimi, senior, was taken out with a small injury. Cameron's definitely showing that he can play, and he's trying to earn that spot on the field.
Now on defense, I saw Genoa playing, but
he's trying to save up that leg. He's definitely working it out right now on the sidelines. Alex looking back for the pass. Another pass to number 40, Bryce Webster. Able to drive forward. You know, it's great seeing some sportsmanship there in between the Vikings and the Zebras.
First and 10 for the Vikings at the Rochester 27-yard line.
17-yard gain.
Under 2 minutes left to play here. Vikings picking it up a bit on the offense. Fake pitch. Hand off to number 13, Jared Dusenberry. You know, Jared's more of an open field style runner, but he's able to get those legs moving. He's 6'3", 181, and it's oftentimes hard to get that size moving in those short little distances.
And he's a large target, so.
Yes, he is.
Did we ever figure out why the flags that have staff,
Gary? Yeah.
And that'll be a timeout. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back. And we're back. Vikings looking for another score before this half is over. We are live at Rochester4.com. Also on Channel 4. Vikings struggling there. Fumbling that.
This doesn't start working. We may have you guys just record it.
This is one of those plays that practice use like once a year.
Under a minute to play in the first half.
Under a minute here. Vikings definitely pushing for this score. Craig rushing forward. You know, the Zebras have definitely been working on containing the Viking offense and not letting Alec roll out to one side or the other.
Yeah.
He's able to get a lot of yards generally. Final play right here of this half. Vikings are going to call a timeout. 11 seconds left to go. Vikings are definitely going to be looking for a score here.
We're going to take a break, and we'll be right back.
And we're back. This is going to be the last play, probably, of the half. 11 seconds left to go. Alec Craig rolling out, looking for the long pass. Number 40, Bryce Webster.
And it is interception.
They're going to call an interception by the Zebras. 2.5 seconds left to play here. You got to wonder if they're going to go for it. With 2 seconds left, they got one play. It's going to be a long shot, or if they're just going to knee it here.
I'm feeling it's just going to be a Hail Mary pass, hoping for the best, and hoping that if it gets picked off, they can stop Valley.
Vikings playing deep. That'll be just a knee for the Zebras. You know, that's going to bring up the end of the first half, and it's halftime now. 7-0 is the score, Vikings in the lead. I'm Jared Michael, and this is Chevy Teeter, and we're live at RTC 4 and Channel 4 on cable. And we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back. And we're back from halftime. Vikings winning currently 7-0 against the Rochester Zebras. I'm Jared Michael with Chevy Teeter.
And I'm Chevy Teeter. A little bit of confusion there.
Right now, currently the score is 7-0. Vikings in the lead. Great night for football. Little chill in the air. This is the Bell game. Vikings versus Zebras.
A lot of hype here at this game.
A lot of hype. Such a close score. The Vikings will be getting the ball to begin with.
Now, the first half of the game, both teams, when they had possession of the ball, they had the ball for a very long period of time, running down the clock very quickly. So it almost makes you wonder if that's going to play out the same way, or we'll see a little bit more of an intense game.
Back to return is number 12, Deshaun Heckman, a senior. To kick for the Zebras is number
27,
who is not listed on the Zebra roster. Oh, I'm sorry, that's number 27, Zane Duff, who's a junior for the Zebras.
Now, I remember Zane Duff from when he went to Valley. He went to Valley in middle school and transferred to Rochester. He was a kicker in middle school, and he was very good at it.
Flag on the play because the ball rolled out of bounds there. Vikings will take over for the first drive of the second half here. You know, Vikings were very run heavy that first half of the game, which is why the clock ran down so fast. It looks like they're going to re-kick it here. Set them further back and giving them a second chance, just trying it again. Let's see how the intensity of these players transfers over. A lot better kick there by Zane. Deshaun Heckman getting the ball, rushing forward. Having a little bit of trouble of trying where to find the running pocket there and just not quite getting it. Brought down around the 25. You know, it was such a high kick, and it had some hang time there that, you know, we're at a time of 11:52, so that was an 8-second kick return, which is much longer than what normally is. That'll be number 5, Alec Craig, handing off to number 12, Deshaun Heckman, both seniors for the Vikings.
Not a huge gain on the play, but a gain that was needed.
Toward the north end zone here at Death Valley. The Vikings in their home green jerseys with the gold pants, the gold helmets, the green Viking horns on the side. Rochester in the road white jerseys with the black eagles, the black helmets, and the R on the zebra stripes on the side of their helmet. Gets a pitch play to Heckman. Heckman gets a nice kick out. DJ has the first down.
And that'll be Heckman showing that he can run. Last week, getting over 100 yards in that game. Definitely Valley's key runner.
definitely one of the key players from Valley.
Craig looking back to pass. Pass intended for Bryce Webster. That'll be his first drop of the night.
Second down is 10 for the Vikings at their own 41-yard line. We'll send Seacrest wide to the right side.
Chris Seacrest, all 5'6", wind up to the right side. We'll answer to Webster, the near side on the second down and 10.
Craig Dotson, Craig, set the line of scrimmage.
Another pass down, third pass down for the nine. Rochester still loose. Who has that? I think Rochester does.
And Rochester is going to take it. On the center quarterback exchange,
a turnover there on downs. No, sorry.
The fumble by the Vikings. Rochester recovering there. Let's see how the Viking defense can do here as they come back from this halftime. This is the first time they're stepping out on the field. 10:36 left to play in the second half. Or in this third quarter of the second half. That'll be Brady Perez keeping the ball, rushing long, getting a touchdown. The first touchdown for the Zebras. That'll bring the score up to 7-6. Vikings in the lead still, 10:27 left to play in the third quarter.
No, that's not looking too good.
No, that is not what Valley wants at all.
Again, 10:27 to play in the third quarter.
Justin Risk.
Duff on to attempt the extra point.
And again, the fumble set the play up. And one
snap
play,
is bad,
high snap.
And the kick is up, and it is good. That'll tie up 7-7 on this game.
Bought a 50-50 raffle ticket. The winning number is 563157. 563157. You can collect your winnings over at the student council table, which is over by the concession stand.
10:27 5 in the third quarter. The Rochester Zebras just tie up the score on a 40-yard touchdown run by Brady.
You know, the Vikings definitely need to get that morale boost that they had in the very first half of this game. Rochester appears to be the team that's come out of the halftime, all pistons firing, ready to go. Valley looking a little sluggish as compared to the first half.
Looks like they may be a little more lax this time.
Again, Zane Duff on the kick. Again, that'll be out of bounds.
What a change of events very quickly here in the first 9 seconds. Valley turns the ball over on a bad snap. Rochester takes advantage of it, and now the Zebras see a little bit of excitement.
You know, Vikings are going to take that. They're not wanting to see Zane's leg again as compared to the last time that he was out there kicking. 10:27 left to play in the third quarter. 7-7 as the Vikings begin their second drive of the third quarter. That'll be number 44, Jonathan Fields, on the carry. He's a senior having a sack earlier on in the game on defense, definitely showing that he's got the quickness that is needed in this game.
That he does.
Think about it a minute, guys.
Just rolls off the tongue.
Oh, what a great name.
Second and four for the Vikings. Craig.
Craig.
Flag on the play.
Defensive back Plummer was offside.
Yeah, big help.
He was lined up to make sure the receiver couldn't get off the blocks, but he was lined up a good yard.
That'll be offsides on the defense. You know, give me first down for the Vikings. It's a great little gift that the Zebras gave them there.
You know, I'm noticing that Valley doesn't seem to be moving to the huddle or very quickly after a play. They're just kind of moseying around out there. It's not a good sight.
Especially not when compared to the first half of this game. Valley was definitely setting the tempo with a very quick-paced tempo, and whoever controls the tempo of the game controls the game itself. Rochester playing a very slow, methodical play style. Valley, when they were controlling the ball, was putting Rochester off of their own ball game. Now Valley's seeming to go to Rochester's tempo, and Rochester is definitely setting the tempo there and setting how this game is being played.
Craig
handing off to number 82, Janoa Melanimi, senior.
Third down and five.
49.
Asbury Apple incident.
In the third quarter, we're tied.
Ball in Rochester territory, 49.
8:26 left to play in the third quarter. Quick little pitch out to Deshaun Heckman.
It looks like there's not going to be any gain, a little bit of a loss actually, bringing out the punt team.
You know, number 13, Jared Dusenberry, senior, is back to punt for the Vikings. So far this game, showing that he's got the leg needed. As compared to earlier on in the season, he's definitely matured. This is his first year punting for the Vikings. That'll be a flag on the play.
Five yards.
And it'll be a 5-yard penalty on the Vikings. Center picked up the ball there, and you can't pick it up like that when you're going to pitch it that far back to the punter. Dusenberry, long kick. Rochester showing that they are great returners. Number 20, Corbin Wood, Jr. on the carry.
As you said, Rita, Mike, you both have said, Rochester's been the team a little more fired up here in the second half.
43, 37, 38, 34. They kept Valley out of the end zone for the first half and built some momentum. And scored quickly to say,
first and 10 for the Z's.
Perez being a deep shotgun formation. Wayne snap at his own 31-yard line. On the physical formation. 37.
Perez.
Three receivers on the right side.
Option going left.
This time. Here comes the
Vikings just not quite being able to wrap up. Finally able to wrap up and bring him down. Well behind the line of scrimmage. Brady Perez just not being able to let go of that ball. Whether that was just an issue of him not finding an open receiver or if it was just a struggle from him being a sophomore and not quite sure what to do with the ball there.
Second down and 19. Three receivers on the right side, one on the left.
Second and 19 for the Z's.
So Perez in the pistol.
Perez up the pistol. Pearson goes in motion to the Rochester sideline.
And they end up at the gut. This time it will be Bryce Addison in fullback position. Gets back to the 30-yard line.
Hand off to number 10, Bryce Abbott, freshman on the carry.
Third down and long. And it looks as Shriver is on the sideline really trying to pump his team up.
You know, not just Shriver. Shriver's pumping his team up, but the players are calling for the fans to get in this game as well. Definitely need it. Oh, Vikings trying to get there. Looks like that'll be holding back there. Number 40, Bryce Webster, almost getting there. And the blocker just not letting go. You know, the fans getting involved, it helps raise the morale for the Vikings.
So the penalty, the line of scrimmage, the third 18 is on the 30. And this flag lays at 26 yards.
So Shriver talking to the line judge, saying what they want to do.
Turn that at the referee. Now, Rochester receivers.
You could very easily be back at the 16-yard line before this is done.
Still deciding things.
And just started to keep taking the
penalty. Good Travis says we're taking it back. Field position.
Again, that was holding, and that is a penalty from the side of the foul of where it happened. That's 10 yards from the spot there. Already far back, 10 yards back further. That's really going to hurt the Zebras there.
Third and long. It's be interesting to see what Rochester tries to do here.
You know, third down and 32 here. 5:57 left to play. Rochester definitely going to be looking for a big play here. Again, that was handoff to number 10, Bryce Abbott, freshman. Just not quite able to do it for the Zebras. That'll bring out the punt squad. We're going to see how good they can do here. So far in this game, not showing that they have good punt legs.
Duff, I know, was very frustrated with his one punt, and he's on to punt now.
You know he has a leg.
They'll set up along his 10-yard line.
Punt this one away.
Conley will set up near midfield for the Vikings.
Receive the punt.
Craig also about the 45. It's a low snap. Kick is away.
High punt. Vikings definitely need to stay away from that. They've had problems so far in this year with wanting to touch the ball when it is not advisable for them to do so. They're going to take over with 5:02 left to play in this third quarter.
Again, the rain has not set in tonight, thank goodness.
First and 10 for the Vikings at the Rochester 47-yard line.
So, Tipping New Valley, 5:02 to go here in the third quarter. Deadlocked at 7. Don't worry, if there's a jinx to be had, I'll say it.
Let's see what the Vikings can do on this possession.
Alec Craig, quarterback, senior, rolling out, showing that speed and athleticism that he has. Definitely driving forward. Rochester so far in this game has had been a good job of containing Alec to the inside and in the pocket. They definitely knew that they would need to contain him if they were going to be successful.
That's because I get kind of crazy. I just like check the sights for the field. If I don't like that, I change the devices.
Craig,
first down and 10 for Tippecanoe Valley. Actually, hand up the middle. DJ didn't have an issue with a good patience.
And that'll be Deshaun Heckman, definitely showing that field sense that he has. Not quite having a hole there off the start of the run. Just that waiting there patiently for the hole to open up and for his blockers to do what they need to do. DJ was able to get far.
Gain of 5 on the play. Blockers. Clock ticks battle of the bell. Melanini is the fullback. Heckman is the tailback. And Craig in the center.
Five.
Craig will roll out of the line.
That'll be rolling out by Alec Craig. Definitely rolling back there far. A lot of pressure by number 31, Ross Pearson, the senior.
No, it's kind of funny. Alec probably just ran nearly 30 yards to gain, what was it, three?
Yeah, yeah. Alec is definitely one of those people that has a hard time moving the ball north and south. He likes to do a lot of east and west travel. The field is 53 yards from sideline to sideline, 100 yards long, and Alec gets, he just likes to get a little bit of extra conditioning in for those sideline to sideline runs. Bouncing back and forth oftentimes, though, however, opens up the field for him, so it works for him. And that'll be a handoff to number 82, Genoa Melanimi, senior. Injured early on in the night. It's great to see him back out on the field on offense. He's been definitely a key player on the defensive side still, but it's good to see that his leg isn't bothering him on the offensive side. That'll be another quarterback keep by Alec, showing how he can rush back and forward, and it looks like that's going to be a score for the Vikings. Flag on the play, however. You know, that cannon goes off, but you got to wonder if that was too early. That'll be a hold on the Vikings. And that'll pull the ball back.
It's very disappointing. Never want to see that happen.
He came all the way to the near sideline and then cut it back. Well,
you know, Alec's got to be frustrated there. Great run there, showing athleticism and skill. However, you know, sometimes it's just hard to understand as a offensive blocker when you should be blocking and when not. Craig, not quite, just almost to the goal line there, and he threw that block and just wasn't quite there and shouldn't have been there. Trying to do his job just ended up causing the penalty.
A lot of work for nothing there.
That'll be a handoff to number 82, Genoa Melanimi. Staying up, flag, and another flag on the play. Looks like that'll be a face mask on the Zebras. You know, pretty easy to tell when Genoa Melanimi Sr. is running backwards being pulled down by that face mask. That'll just tack it on to the end of that run there, definitely putting him half the distance to the goal, very close for the goal. Tied 7-all, 3:19 left to play here in the third quarter. Vikings definitely need a score here. This is the battle of the bell. Tensions are high on the field and in the stands.
And surprisingly, a very close scoring game. And this one might be close.
Now, it was a fumble there on the Vikings. They were able to recover.
There'll be second and goal from the four.
Yeah, yeah.
Two
for the
play in the third quarter. Collie and Melanie. Craig
again under center.
High back formation. Craig under center.
Points the snap.
Grabs a snap.
Hand off to Melanie.
That'll be a handoff to number 82, Genoa Melanimi. Fighting. Foot by foot, trying to get inching forward there. Trying to get that. Definitely clawing forward, not quite able to get there. That'll bring up third and goal.
Play clock at 23. 3. Game clock at 2:11 to go in the third quarter. Deadlocked 7-yard for the battle of the bell. Valley and Rochester. Conley is the tailback. Craig under center. Melanie is the fullback.
Craig under center with 10 on the play clock. Takes a snap.
That'll be Alec rolling out wide. Able to get the touchdown, rushing forward there. And there's the cannon that we've been expecting. And it's great to have that back out on the field as the Vikings are trying to bring back some past traditions. That'll be the Vikings' second touchdown of the night. Score 13-7. Vikings in the lead. Kick is up. And that'll be another good kick by number 51, Domingo Santiago. You know, he's a freshman, but he's got a great leg on him, definitely showing what he can do.
The cheer block definitely looks excited.
Rochester's cheer block also cheering wide.
Wabash in the third quarter in South Lincoln 7 here at Tippecanoe Valley.
Vikings back to kick for the first time of this second half.
Jose Rivera will kick off the Vikings toward the north end zone.
Brad Thomas, I'm David Wilson in the kickoff.
Everett Rivera kicks it away. And
pick off to number 20, Corbin Wood Jr. You know, he's had some great returns this entire night. Definitely showing what he can do.
You love to see the shirts. You love to see the zebra head on a stick by the student body out there.
You know, people ask me.
First and 10 for the Rochester Zebras, now down by 14-7. They came out of the huddle.
Crowd is stuck around here.
Corbin Wood, the low receiver to the near side.
147 to go.
Out of behind
Perez. Perez back to pass. He's got a man out there.
That is a pass to number 20, Corbin Wood. You know, he's been a very good player for the Zebras.
Very key player.
Otherwise, it was six.
First and 10 for the Zebras. 40-yard line. Ball in the near hash.
We'll have Abbott behind it.
Wood. And Dalton wide to the near side.
Two receivers allowed to the right for the Zebras.
Pearson wide to the left side. Out of the pistol. Ice snap. Pulls it down.
That'll be Abbott. A handoff to number 10, freshman Bryce Abbott for the Zebras.
Second and 8 for Rochester. Down to a minute to go in the third quarter. Tippecanoe Valley 14, Rochester 7.
The Zebras, the play comes in. Jacob Good will bring the play in from the sideline.
Coming in will be
under 20 on the play clock.
Jacob Good.
Under 50 seconds on the game clock.
And the Zebras will come out with, again, two receivers on the left side.
Pearson and Good, wide left side.
Pearson and Good,
two receivers in here. We're down to 9 on the play clock, out of the pistol.
Perez in the pistol.
Perez takes the snap.
There will be a flag on the play there.
Receiver to the near side. Got a half-second jump on that. And make it a second down and 12 for Rochester.
That was 25-20 out of Woodco. Apparently, Manchester must have restricted the kick.
Five penalties for 29 yards from the Zebras. Vikings have 4 for 24.
Rochester on a
five. Vikings with five first downs this half. And Rochester now has their second.
Second down.
Again, Rochester, the big scorer this half came from Perez. Valley responds with a nice long drive.
You know, Vikings still trying to get that crowd hyped up there.
And Perez gets the play call from Joe Grant. Play clock at 15. Game clock at 26.
24 seconds to play in the third quarter.
Two receivers left. Looking at second down and 13 after the penalty. On a second down and 13 to the Valley, 43.
Out of the pistol, Brady Perez takes the snap.
Perez, on the option, throws it out to the left side.
You know, freshman Bryce Abbott just not quite able to get up there. Rochester's offensive line not able to hold him. You know, we're going to take a quick break and we'll be right back. And we're back. That was the end of the third quarter. Fourth quarter starting here. 12 minutes left to go here. 14-7, Vikings in the lead. That'll be quarterback Brady Perez back. Long pass. And that will be a reception. Pass was complete there.
Great play from Rochester there.
Great play. Right through the hands of the Viking defender.
You know, I'm thinking that Rochester is really wanting this to be a close game. They're going to do anything they can to knock some more points on the board. And
oh, yeah, and if you remember, the Rochester has the bell. You can see it over there on the sidelines. They do not want to give that up whatsoever to the Vikings.
That they do not.
Abbott again running, showing a ferocity we haven't seen this game from him so far.
Rochester. Second down and one. A lot of things they could go here. Valley looking
here's
for
an emotion from the right side. Side. Just stacked. Have it right up the middle.
Abbott goes nowhere. He loses the yard.
Very quick stop from the Vikings, and Abbott a little slow getting up, but looks to be fine. Seems just to be because of frustration.
10.5 minutes to go in the fourth.
Back at about the 11-yard line.
Tamina Valley 14, Rochester
7. Down a long two.
The Zebras, you got believer in four down territory here.
Looking for Abbott to either run or pass here.
Perez will set up. He's got 2 men in the backfield this time. As Dalton will join Abbott and Perez.
You know, the tension is definitely high right now as the Zebras are looking to tie it up here with 10 left to play in the game.
You know, you think, what would it hurt for Rochester to go for it here?
Nothing at all here. They definitely need the score. One yard to go. Fourth down. Stakes are very high. Vikings definitely need a stop here. And that'll be a timeout for the Zebras. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be right back. And we're back. 9:28 left to play in the game. 14-7, Vikings leading. 4-1 for the Zebras here as they look to tie up the game. That'll be a handoff to number 30, Wilson Dalton. And that'll look like it. It's a turnover on downs for the Vikings, exactly what they needed. You can tell the fans are definitely happy for that. You know, hopefully the Vikings can keep morale high here and get the ball down the field.
And hopefully they can play smart, Jared. They've had some troubles with fumbles, and they just want to make sure they can keep a hold of the ball because as of now, we still do have the lead.
I'm Jared Michael here, commentating with Chevy Teeter. 8:55 left to play in this game. And it looks like the Vikings are going to be able to draw the Zebras offsides there.
It was interesting to see right before that fourth down play, as we were in that timeout, Alec Craig, of course, was not playing defense, came over and got a drink, and somebody shot something.
We started that.
I really am saying hi, but it was like, hey, we're going to bring this up. Even though that quarterback exchange has left something to be desired.
First and five for the Vikings at their own 10-yard line.
First down and five now, following the penalty against the Zebras. Craig under center. Hands it off to Heckman. Heckman with the first down.
And that'll be Deshaun Heckman on the long rush, held up by his jersey, definitely fighting against it. Just moving those legs, fighting and fighting and fighting. Vikings have got a drive for them, almost like somebody's lit a fire underneath them.
They just got to keep that morale up and keep the drive going.
You know, I think that's what it boils down to, Chevy, morale. The Zebras came out of the half with very high morale, and right now the Vikings have seemed to match that. They're going back to that quick tempo style that they had early on in the game. Senior Janoa Melanimi on the carry there.
Marked it up near the 48-yard line. Valley needs to get to the 42. Clock runs with 7:54 to go here in the fourth. Valley 14, Rochester 7. Vikings held a 7-0 advantage.
That'll be an interception by the Vikings. Wes Melanson, number 15 there.
Great play by the Vikings there.
Vikings definitely showing they're willing to play here. 3:50 left to go, 21-7. Vikings in the lead as they're going to take over here. If they can get a score here, that's just going to put the nails on the coffin. I really don't see the Zebras being able to come back from yet another score if Vikings are able to score on this drive. Heckman rolling out.
Another great run from DJ Heckman.
However, flag on the play.
Let's hope that isn't on Valley.
So he's away from the play. I know there. So we'll bring up a first down and 20 for Tippecanoe Valley.
And that'll be holding on the Vikings. That'll be 10 yards from the site of the foul. But it's still first down because the Vikings were able to pick up a first down there. Valley cheer block definitely showing a pride in the Vikings. You know, we're even able to, Chevy and I are even able to hear them all the way up here in the cheer or in the press box.
You can almost feel the rumble from the stands. And there is 3 minutes left in the game tonight.
You
may be right.
All these have contributed to a 2-touchdown lead for Valley.
At the Vikings,
second down 19, down to 2:40 to go in this fourth quarter. Play clock down to 5. Number 7.
Quick pitch out to number 12, Deshaun Heckman, brought down quick by number 31, Ross Pearson.
I think Rochester is definitely keying on him because he's been such a go-to player.
You know, and you can expect that from your senior leaders. Ross is a senior, and he's able to push the team to whole new levels. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back.
And we are back.
2:31 left to play in the game. 21-7, Vikings in the lead. Third and very long. Alec pitches out to number 12, Deshaun Heckman. Long, wide open field there as Heckman's going to try to drive forward. Picks up the first down, finally pushed out of bounds.
And that is exactly what Valley needed there. And he definitely couldn't have done that without his blocks.
You know, Heckman has already surpassed the 100 yards in a night, which he had last week at Manchester. Looks like he's going for 200 yards with this playing style that he has tonight.
And it's definitely possible.
Another pitch out to Heckman. able to break away from a would-be tackler, but it slowed him down enough to where he was able to get wrapped around by the Zebras. Still a great run by Heckman. Two-minute drill as it's 1:50 left here to play. Vikings in possession, score 21-7. That'll be another handoff to Deshaun Heckman. Rochester swarming over him as they're starting to get used to him being the ball carrier. Rochester's going to use their last timeout here. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be right back.
And we are back. There is 1 minute and 25 seconds left in the game, and the score is 21-7, Vikings ahead. Great play playing by the Vikings this game.
You know, Rochester all out of timeouts. Vikings really just looking for a first down here, and that'll be the end of the game as they can just let the play clock wind down. Vikings are going to go for it. The players definitely calling for the fans to get louder, to get hyped up, and to join in. Under a minute left to play here. Ten seconds here on the play clock. Vikings need a first down here. Alex going to roll out.
And that's a first down for Vikings.
You know, all they need here is just a knee it, and that'll be the game.
First down on the play.
Looks like number five, Alec Craig, slow to get up. Looks like that'll be another W for the Vikings as they win, bringing a new lead for the Vikings that they haven't had this entire season. That'll be a win, and the Vikings will get back the bell from the Rochester Zebras. Score 21-7. Vikings winning. Some key players of the game for the Zebras would be number 15, the quarterback Brady Perez, showing that he has athleticism both on the offense and defense. Number 20, Corbin Wood, definitely had some great returns on the night. And number 31, Ross Pearson for the Zebras. Ross was definitely a good receiver and runner. For the Vikings, we have number 5, Alec Craig, for his athleticism, running the ball. Number 12, Deshaun Heckman, showing that he really, really wanted that ball with running and having well over 100 yards in this game. Number 82, Genoa Melanimi, after an early injury, coming back and fighting through that. And number 40, Bryce Webster, with some very clutch catches on the night. Thanks for watching Tippecanoe Valley Football on RTC TV, and check out www.rtc4.com for more videos.